Ohayo, sekai, good morning, world. Dore hodo aruita o ashi no itami dake. Alright then guys, we're gonna go ahead and find ourselves a little newbie that we can help out. Hey there, yeah, you.
Who, me?
Hey, you look like a new player to me. Would you like some newbie guidance, my man?
I'm not really new, I've been playing for a while now and I have pretty.
Awesome, glad to work with you. First, we're going to start off with the most basic of basic money making on SpawnPK.
You just told you I'm not new.
Shut the fuck up, man. You're new now. Now show us how to make money, man. When you are brand new to SpawnPK yourself, the first thing you want to do is go to YouTube, type in SpawnPK and see what videos come up. Preferably you press the little filter button and make it on this week, that way you get the most recent videos, and then you see if there are any videos that have giveaways on them, such as this video, because we're doing a $50 bond giveaway for you guys. All you need to do is, of course, subscribe to the channel, like this video, comment your in-game name down below, and turn on the post notifications. You've done all of that, you entered the giveaway on this video, and just like me, there are many others who do the same thing. Giveaways are always a fun little thing. You can have a good chance of winning them. There usually are between 100 and 200 people, depending on who you're viewing, obviously, and how much the giveaway is. However, generally speaking, it's always good to shoot your shot. With that being said, if you are new to SpawnPK, you know, you haven't even tried it yet, this might be the video that convinces you for once in your life to hop onto SpawnPK yourself, then please do use the link in the description. There's also a link available right there for my Discord channel. Make sure you join that. There's a ton more giveaways, updates, and all that good shit. Just join it and you'll see for yourself. With that being said, let's move on to actual real money making tips, because entering giveaways is never a guarantee. Alright then, so you're a newbie, you just logged on to SpawnPK, and you have no clue what to start off doing whatsoever. Let me tell you, the first most important step you're gonna do is type ... vote. And that's all you need to do, and then vote for all of these websites. We're gonna do that real quick and I'll show you guys what happens. Alright, I just voted for all four of the websites on my other screen, and then you're gonna claim real quick, and just like that, you get yourself a bunch of little items that are, you know, decently useful, but more importantly, we get some amazing vote points. Right here, you receive 4 vote points and 8 repair scrolls. So let's go over what you get real quick. 150 mil cash, not too interesting. 25 blood money, that's a lot of money at the moment, they're going for around 25 mil each, so you'll have a little bit of starter cash. Some bloodlust scrolls, you can activate them and temporarily get plus 10 blood money from kills for 5 minutes. And then you have repair scrolls, which can be used to repair untradeable items that, you know, get destroyed on death, and then you have to repair them to wear them again. Same system as old school RuneScape. But the most important part about that entire thing are the vote points. So if we go home real quick and run over here to the shops, you will see that there's a little vote shop right here. Trade this person and you can buy these vote tickets. So you get your first 4 vote tickets, same thing, run over to a trading post and just, you want to chug them in right there. Let's see what the price is. Okay, so they're going, okay, ignore this one. They usually go for around this price at the moment. It's a ridiculous amount. So 1.1 bill each. We're gonna chug them in for 1 bill, hopefully they'll sell real quick. And then we're gonna use that money to make our first little bit of gear upgrades. I'm also gonna sell the 25 block money for relatively cheap, because you know, every little bit you can get, you should go for. 17.5 mil each is what I'm doing. Hopefully it'll sell quick enough. That should be one of the cheaper block monies in the TP. And then you wait. Alright then, a little while later, your stuff should have sold just like that. Bloom, you take out your money and boom, you have your first 4.4 bill cash and you literally just logged in. That's how easy it is. Now what item are we going to buy? Because items can be quite expensive. But blowpipe costs only 4 bill at the moment and we just happen to have enough for that. Now with that blowpipe, we're gonna go and make ourselves a little range setup real quick. You can use this hourglass, I don't know what it's called, I'm calling it an hourglass, I know that's not the correct word, but this thingy, and go to the search button and search for an item that you want to spawn. For example, we want a Carol's little type of setup, so we're gonna spawn ourselves some carols just like that. And then you have a little overlay screen on the right. Once you have a full setup, we're gonna copy it. I'll show you when I get to that. Alright, I'm almost all done with my setup. The only item that I can't actually spawn is an artist ring. So we're gonna see if we can purchase one of those with the money we have left. We currently still are rocking 587 mil, which is plenty. Well, not plenty. We can just barely buy an artist ring eye. And that's what we're gonna do. And just with that, our entire setup is complete. And now we have a nice little newbie setup to make our first little bit of cash. Now, as you can see, I finally have the overlayout thingy right here on the right available to us. So what you're gonna do is make a new setup. If you haven't yet, just with the create button, I called it on new, and then click on clone, clone to new, yes, and it will automatically copy everything that you have set up. So your prayer book, your mage book, as well as what your inventory looks like. This is what I'm rocking, 2 ranger potions and a few super restores. That's all you're gonna need. And the first thing we're gonna do is go to Undead PKers. Why, you ask? Because it has a beautiful daily task that gives us a treasure casket. So we're gonna need to kill 50 Undead PKers. Let's do that real quick. Just click teleport and start killing. Pray melee, use range pray. It's pretty self-explanatory, guys. Look, boom, there you go. Aww. While we are killing them, I'm just gonna give you guys a few tips. First of all, the community isn't always that friendly to new players, but I would still recommend trying to make friends. Just have a little chat, ask what people are up to, are they doing their daily tasks, are they just killing them for Slayer, for fun, whatever. Make a little bit of conversation. First tip, never fucking beg for items, never ask people for stuff. That shit is so incredibly looked down upon, and for good reason, because money making isn't all that difficult and you just come over like a really greedy prick if all you're gonna do is ask for items. So just don't do that. Instead, just make conversation with people. If they want to give you some stuff and they see you're a newbie, they will probably help you out. At least some people will. So don't ask for it. If they want to give it to you, you will get it, but just genuinely don't ask for it. We earlier saw that Regar is actually locked and we can't activate that prayer. To unlock that, we need to unlock a blood perk, which is pretty expensive and pretty something you get later on in the game. So we're not really gonna get into that at the moment. But what we're focusing on here at the Undead PKS are these daily tasks. Some give really good ones, like the Battle Mages. The Brutal Dragons are okay. This gives you a few build, but nothing too special. The ones you really want to look out for are these treasure caskets. Not gonna lie, PKing, even though it's a SpawnPK server, I would not recommend going into the wildy straight off after starting, because you're just not gonna stand a lot of a chance against a lot of players that have way better gear, decked out special attack weapons. You're not gonna stand a chance. So first, get your basics done and then move on to other things. The first things we're gonna do is see if there are any dailies that give us something like the treasure casket or something like this. 50 blood money is a few hundred mil, that's pretty decent. If you wanna do a little bit of, what's it called, a little bit of thieving to start off your journey, anything can go. But this is what we're gonna focus on, and I'll see you guys in a few more kills. Undead PKers also have a quite good drop table. They have an uncommon drop for the Chaotic Mystery box, as well as a goodie bag, bandless pieces, and a useless bed that no one wants. But I just loot everything in general if I were you, and if you're lucky, there are even sometimes people that leave their loot completely on the floor, such as coins that you can loot for a few mil each, or even the more expensive drops, because these do sell for a decent amount. I would sell the rings to the shop, sell these in the TP, but I'll show you guys once we're done with the task. And this is going to be the last Undead PKer for me. Unfortunately, we didn't see any Chaotic Mystery boxes or goodie bags or anything like that. I mean, odds are pretty slim of landing one of those drops in only a few kills. But there is our treasure caskets, that's what we did it for. And then we have all the extra loot on top of that to sell for a little bit of extra cash. We made around 400 mil from doing these, so that's pretty good in and of its own. We go to the shops again and we trade the coin shop. We can actually sell our regular rings right over here, at least the Berserker and Archer ring, and Dragon Defenders as well for 12 mil each, so that stacks up quite nicely. Tokar calls, they were going into the TP for like, I don't even know, 50 mil each? Ah no, okay, they dropped a lot in price again, they're around 30 mil I would say. I would just put them in for 30 mil, why not? Make sure you put it on coins, otherwise it will be way too expensive in the TP, because 30 mil bags would be a lot. As you can see right here, the cheapest treasure casket in the TP is 75 bags. We're gonna sell it for the same price. That should sell relatively quickly. if we're lucky. And I'm just gonna wait for that. Normally, if I were you, I would do something while you're selling it. So try to have a look at the money-making ones and see which ones actually give one of those caskets. You could do battle mages, for example, in a very low-risk setup. Just kill them, don't loot anything, like the tokens they drop. And a treasure casket, obviously, that is the main reason why you would want to go there. You can do brutal dragons as well, for example. Only 35 kills done relatively quickly. Good drop table as well, so you could make a little bit extra. And then 500 mil plus 1.5 billion point boxes, a little bit of blood money and dragon bones. Really good to start off on. Same with player killing, not the best. Same with pure, and then you have the barrows one, but that doesn't have a really high reward anymore. It literally only took me like 3 minutes of waiting and it finally sold. Boom, there is your first 8 bill cash on top of that blowpipe, and you're gonna buy yourself a Slayer Hound with it. Normally they are a bit cheaper than 6.5 bill, but I actually bought all of them out earlier, so that's a big rip right there. But that doesn't really matter, you need this Slayer Helm, because it's a huge DPS bonus in comparison to not having the helm. So we're gonna bank our little cash and all of the items. What we're gonna do now is gear up for Revenants. I need my Slayer Helm that I banked. Oops, those are giveaway items. Bloop! And there is a huge DPS increase. Once you reach this early on stage, there are kind of three options that you have that you can take. You can go the efficiency route, which is basically trying to upgrade your gear as best as possible and just go for the max DPS, max money per hour wherever you go. The second route is the safe route, which would be you would go for pets that will help you reduce your risk. For example, if you want to do things in the wilderness, a Yoshi pet will help you with that because it automatically banks the majority of drops that you get. A few places are limited, such as the Mage Arena. But other than that, the Yoshi will bank all your items, so if you get a good drop, you will never risk it on death. Or for example, the alien pet, which will allow you to teleport above level 30 wilderness. And the third route is the achievement round. If you do want to finish off your account, get the achievement capes that are available on this game, and you have a trained account, for example, obviously you have the option of training first before you do anything else and trying to go for the achievements. For example, right over here, our first vote gave us the little supporter one. I didn't even notice that, by the way, early on, otherwise I would have claimed it. But there is an extra 5 bill just like that, just for voting the first time. Let's see if there's anything else. We also did the baller one. Yeah, I've done that in the past when I trade a lot of money for metal. Ignore that one, I suppose. But the point is, if you do want to go for the achievements, then maybe it might be more efficient for you to take a little detour and, for example, do 100 in that PKS first. Or personally, I would wait for the next day so you can do your daily again and finish this one off as you do. But you could, for example, go ahead and start your Slayer task and start training Slayer instead of doing the most efficient moneymakers. But for this scenario, we're gonna start up with a straight-up moneymaker, which is Blood Revenants. Blood Revenants spawn all over the wilderness. Anywhere you go, you have a chance of finding them. And they have an insane drop table, plus the fact that there's a 1 in 100 chance for them to spawn a Superior Revenant. And the Superior Revenant has even better drop table. It's freaking insane. We're gonna get to that in just a second. I'll show you guys what to bring, what to use, etc. But here is kind of the drop table for a regular Revenant. So 1 in 1000 for a prize key or a lava key, and 1 in 2500 for a grand prize key. You see that more often than you would expect, even for these drop rates. But the grand prize key, for example, is over 100 bill. So if you get one of those, you're set. And there is also, of course, the Superior Blood Revenant, which has a way better drop table. I mean, it's a 1 in 100 chance for spawning, but once it's spawned, it can drop some amazing shit. So we're gonna go get into that, get geared up, and hunt ourselves a little Blood Revenants. Alright, so since I said we're going for the efficiency route, the first thing I would love to unlock to improve our money per hour is the Treasure Fairy. This is a pet that will follow you around. You can't lose pets on death unless you are Red Skulled. Just never type Red Skull in the chat and you should be all good on that. The Treasure Fairy costs around 20 bill, I do believe. Yeah, 18 bill is the cheapest one right there. Not even a lot of money considering the votes are 1 bill each. We just got 8 of them on the first day. Tomorrow we'll get another 4 of those. The Treasure Caskets are 7.5 bill each. A Treasure Fairy isn't that hard to get. That's one item we definitely want to unlock. And the other one is a way higher one called the Twisted Bow. You all know it, 300 bill. It's a long-term commitment. You're gonna have to grind a little bit more for that. But a few other options you have are the Yoshi Pet, which will help you with risk reducing and ensuring that all your drops are banked. Pretty expensive as well. And a colored Slayer Helm, which has increased stats. It doesn't find it like that. It has increased stats on top of a regular one. The normal one gives 25% damage, and a colored one will give 35%. And then you also have the Fused Slayer Helm, which has even better options and bonuses to it, like anti-venom, anti-fire, all that stuff. But all the colored Slayer Helms are kind of the same, so you just want to get the cheapest one, which is currently 60 bill. We don't have that yet. Let's go ahead and find some revenants. All right, we're gonna go to right over here, pking teleport. That's the one you want to use, and then go to brutal dragons. This will teleport you to level 12 wilderness. At the moment, we don't have anything to teleport away with above level 20 wilderness. One of the things you could get for that is an amulet of eternal glory that should allow you to teleport to level 30, or if you have a completion escape, that would also work. But we have neither of those, so what we're gonna do is just sprint around and hopefully find ourselves a few revenants. Pro tip number two, if you're not an idiot like me, you will bring stamina pots. And there is our first revenant. Like you can see, it's like a little red pokeball on the minimap. I would also recommend you guys join yourself a little clan chat. Survive is very new player friendly. You can just join it after you log on for the first time. So highly recommend Survive if you want to join an easy little clan chat. That way you can call out for help if anything happens. It's not a PK clan, but it might happen that someone is around and they'll come to you. So if, for example, you run out of run like me, if you don't have stamina, just teleport home and use that little button and you will get your spec back. But we are going to buy a few stamina pots to speed up the process. Give us a lucky superior. Hopefully we can get one early on. That is the best thing that can happen to you, obviously, but you gotta get lucky on that. Another trip has been survived. Anyway, this is how you're slowly going to build up that bank value with the blood money, the coins, and even a few potions. Revenant teleports sell for a little decent amount at least. So yeah, you're just gonna kind of continue with that. And I have the wrong setup. Alright, we have 1.4 billion cash straight up with another 5 bill from the TP. We are definitely getting ourselves a Eternal Glory. That should help tons. Rubbing this amulet will allow you to teleport home at level 30 wilderness. Thank you, and it also counts as a Fury Ornament, so it has slightly better stats from what we were using before. There is a tournament starting in 10 minutes. If you are new, I would highly recommend participating in them. Everyone has the same gear, so it's really a skill thing when it comes to a tourney like hybriding, but more so a luck thing whenever another tournament starts, like max PKing or no armor, things like that. They are very luck reliant, and you can get lucky too, so always participate in those. But instead, I'm gonna use that as an opportunity for less people in the wild and hunt even more revenants. Revenants everywhere. One up there, two down here, and another one right there. Hopefully no one else shows up. God damn it, always. And this should be the last revenant I had to do for my daily, which will give me an extra 200 block money. That's a lot of money at the moment. Like 200 block money is nearly 4 billion cash. I'm gonna sell my block money for around 18 mil each, because that way it sells a little bit quicker. But there we go, 200 Revenant Eaver, kind of neglectable, same with their spec restores. But they stack up nicely, 5 mil each, so if you have a bunch of them, you might be able to sell them for a decent price. But 200 blood money is very much wanted and needed. Majority of our blood money already sold for 13.4 bill. Easiest money you'll ever make. With the money in my bank, that might be enough. Ooh, that might really cut it close for a treasure fairy, actually. If the one in there is still for 18 bill, it is not. RIP. I have to say, I'm a little bit of a dummy dumb. First of all, I'm not using my glory, which is stupid in its own right. But I did forget a very important item that is very good to bring with you, even though it might be a little expensive at the moment. And those are Swift Gloves, because those drastically increase your DPS overall by, you know, giving a chance of double hitting with your blowpipe slash whatever you use. And there's another 2.5 bill, but now I don't have enough for a fairy still because of those Swift Gloves. Another Wicked Vettion is spawning, so we're gonna go ahead and do that real quick so I can show you guys how that's done. First, we need to quickly grab 500 mil cash and buy a orb right here from Risky Rick. Open his shop and buy the cheapest one. There we go. And quickly grab some food and teleport to Vedion. But boss teleports. Find Vedion right here, second option, teleport there. And then let's wait for it to spawn and kill it. Oh my, that's a lot of drops. Did anyone get anything good? Ancient crossbow in someone's name. I don't think we ended up being one of the lucky guys. Nah, it doesn't look like it. Let's see our loot nonetheless, if we can find it in this huge pile of plays. A lot of drops nonetheless, that's for sure. Love to see it. 23 blood money and 100 mil cash. Not the best, but doable. Totally worth doing at least. To be a bit more risky, but more rewarding, you can also bring this 500 mil orb with you to Revenant, and it will increase your odds ever so slightly of getting a superior spawn. I believe the 500 mil makes it 1 in 90 instead of 1 in 100, but if you have the highest orb of all, which is around 50 bill, you have to use the enchanted chest to get it, but it will literally half it and make it 1 in 50 to get a superior. So this one definitely might be worth the best buck for your money, because you get 10% more of a drop rate on a superior spawn while only risking 500 mil more. They are always lost in depth, so even if you have a plus one available, you would still lose it, but it's only 500 mil, and a few kills could easily pay out for that. As a matter of fact, a Revenant spawn is nearly guaranteed to be profit on 500 mil. Alright, let's see what we get from our second Vedion kill. Any luck this time around? Not for me. Wow, look at all those boot drops. Guardian boots times two. Yeah, two different people got guardian boots. Three different people, lol. That's insane. But we get a little bit of blood money. 12 only this time, damn. Waited a little bit longer and it finally dropped down in price after someone sold it for a little bit cheaper. So now we finally have our treasure fairy, boosting up our drop rate by 15%. I also managed to lose my archer ring because I didn't think about risking that. Big oopsie, but you don't lose that much. The malevolent barrel chest has just risen. I don't think I'm gonna make that though. Yeah, I totally did not make that, but there is a blood revenant right there if it wasn't taken away in front of my face like that. Oh well. Alright then guys, and with all of that just in a few hours of doing some revenants and, you know, a few hours of starting up the account, I had already gotten my blowpipe, my slayer helm, and a treasure fairy pet. From there on out, it is just kind of getting repetitive. Make sure you vote every single day to get those bills from that. Make sure you do the good dailies that you can do, such as Mage Bank and the Undead PKers. Anything that gives a treasure casket might be worth considering, except for ones that are too difficult for what you have at the moment in game, such as the PKing ones. And the pure one is one you could consider. If it ends up being the pure hotspot, which you can check in the quest tab, then it might be worth going pure PKing. Even as a new account, just using the dark bow with a granite bow, for example, you could still relatively easy get kills, and there is even a very nice little achievement that you can unlock called the pure IV. It is just barely not in the screen, let me move that around real quick. There we go, 350 pure kills, and it will give you an M chest as well as a prize key, so that is very nice overall. Plus the pure 3 also gives a prize key and a donator M box, so all the pure achievements together gives you over 150 bill just by doing those. So if it ends up being the pure hotspot, try going there, get some kills over there. There are a few other money making methods that I really do want to give a quick shout out to. First of all, any events such as the Halloween event that we used to have last month, or for example the upcoming Christmas event. Events are usually very good money no matter what it is. Ryan always adds something that is quite easy to do even for new players, and usually it ends up being a ton of profit for low effort. Another one would be to start merching. For this I want to refer to Tin Merchmon, my other merching account series, where I started with 200 bill and within a month I had made over a trill just from TP standing. So imagine doing that on the sides, or every time you bank you check the TP real quick, try to make some quick merges here and there. Over time you will see it add up. Very, very good money maker right there. Other than that, we also have the VIP zone. This is a $500 rank. You can also buy it in game, you don't have to donate for it, but it is pretty much later on in the game. Once you have a little bit more money, your gear is a little better, you got yourself a T-bow, maybe a fused Slayer helm, and you want to get that $500 rank so you can go to the VIP zone. This is a very, very profitable zone for AFKing, so if you're doing things on the side and you can't play very actively, doing things like King Black Dragon or Chaos Elemental can end up giving you bills per hour if you camp it out for an X amount of hours in a row. It's a very, very good thing. You can also boost it in the future with Grand Ring Eye, drop rate items, and all of that good shit. And lastly, of course, one of the best money makers in SpawnPK altogether is raids. For this, you do need some really high-end gear and also a ton of pre-kill count in raids to get to the really good money part of it, because you start out on normal raids with 0 PC, which just doesn't give a lot of good loots. But once you've reached 150 kill count, you unlock master raids, and from there on out, you will really start seeing those profits shooting up incredibly much in comparison to the normal ones. And Grandmaster, that's where the big bucks are. TOB is coming to SpawnPK very soon as well. I'm expecting that to be one of the better money makers in the game in its entirety. Most likely just based on what the raid 2 items are in and of its own, but it also comes with new pets and new other items, so can't wait to see that happen as well. But raids is something to consider. It is very, very doable in low tier gear. If I refer to my RTU episodes back in the day when it was like episode 18 to 20 and I first started doing raids, I was using absolutely shit gear and I still managed to do it just fine. There are plenty of tutorials out there, just look one up and you can do it at any time really, but try to get that 150 KC once you have some decent gear and you'll really start pulling in a lot of loot. Obviously, one of the non-mentioned things in this entire video so far has been PKing. Obviously, PKing can be very, very profitable. Tier 10s, good loots, all of that stuff. However, this is an entire different section. And as a new player, I just wouldn't recommend jumping into the wilderness right away due to how SpawnPK is. There are a lot of veterans on this game, so a lot of players that have really decked out gear, special attack weapons like the Dragon Hunter Lance, the Balmung, things that will absolutely annihilate you as a spawnables newbie. So instead of just jumping right into the wildy, I would recommend you first build up your bank a little bit, get some better gear, maybe some Vestas, unlock some things from the Blood Fountain like the Blood Whip so you actually have a chance against these guys. Let me know what you guys thought of this video. I know it's a bit on the basic side, but I still feel like I touched a lot of different grounds. If there is still a lot of questions left, I would definitely be willing to make a part 2 to this video and answer all of those questions and go more in depth on other types of moneymakers as a maybe separate guide tutorial type of deal. So for example, if someone says how does Mage Bank work, I could have a little section on Mage Bank, how you do it, what do you bring, what gear. If you guys ask me how do you do the superiors, I kind of showed it in the video in this one, but if you guys want more information on that or what pets do, there are a lot of guides on the forums as well. But I feel like this would be the most clarification video for when you first log on to SpawnPK and you have no clue what to do. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to join my Discord, enter the giveaway and all of the good stuff. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Metal Raimon out.